Now to our NewsHour share, something that caught our eye that might be of interest to you too. Some people collect stamps, some coins, or in the case of our founding co-anchor Jim Lehrer, anything to do with buses. But one Virginia man owns dozens of giant sculptures of our nation's commanders-in-chief. To mark President's Day, the NewsHour's Julia Griffin has paid his collection a visit.
Cracked and crumbling, battered and broken, these are the faces of President's Park. The 10-acre tourist destination outside of Colonial Williamsburg opened in 2004. The main attraction? 43 Texas-sized busts of presidents past by Houston artist David Addix. Utility contractor Howard Hankins helped build the original park.
The eyes look like they're staring at you, you know, just gazing at you. It's incredible how big they are and lifelike.
The statues are big, but attendance was low, and the venture went belly up in 2010.
When the President's Park was forced to close, the presidential busts were destined for a landfill. Rather than let that happen, Hankins decided to bring them here, to his family farm in Virginia.
But the steel and concrete sculptures weigh between 15 and 20,000 pounds, and moving them wasn't exactly an easy lift.
So I got a ladder, climbed up on top, popped a hole in their head, and rocked them loose from the frame with about a 70,000-pound machine, and picked them up and put them on my low boys and brought them here.
Abraham Lincoln, in particular, took a beating.
Lincoln over there, we dropped him on his back of his head. We had tires to cushion it, and the chain broke, and we dropped him.
The bus can be repaired, but for now, Hankins lets the elements take their toll.
Being out of concrete, water gets in and freezes and cracks them. They kind of have character the way they are. I mean, a little mold and moss on them, crack here and there.
Even though it's private land, intrepid explorers with their selfie sticks still flock to the farm for a glimpse of the stone-faced leaders.
I have to tell them, you know, this is not a site to visit, and I'm nice as I can be. I let them walk around and look, and they try to climb on them. No climbing on the statues, please.
Rather than relegate the bus to an unofficial tourist attraction, Hankins recently started raising funds for a new park outside of Richmond, one that will include two new additions, Presidents Barack Obama and Donald Trump. Until then, Hankins will keep a close watch over his commanders-in-chief.
Yeah, these guys seem to get along out here pretty well. I don't see anybody fight.
It's all bipartisan now.
Yeah. Very good people.
Once they retire.
They all listen to me.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Julia Griffin in Croker, Virginia.
It's another way of thinking about our presidents. And on the NewsHour online right now, we test your knowledge of all things presidential with our President's Day quiz. All that and more is on our website, pbs.org/NewsHour. It's not easy.